Now, does leasing even make sense? What I'm going to discuss is how a lease works and leasing versus financing briefly, and then we'll find out if it makes sense for you. Now, more specifically on how an equipment lease works. Essentially, the lessor is the lender, buys the equipment, and then rents or leases it back out to you. A lessor will set up payment amounts and a term, a number of payments. You've heard of rent to own, haven't you? Well, it's basically the same thing. The only difference is that a rental doesn't usually have a requirement to keep the items rented. For example, you go to the furniture rental place, rent a couch for $12 a week. 3 months later, you don't want it anymore. You return it. No more contract. Leasing equipment has a contract, a predetermined payment and term. You can't really take it back because the lessor doesn't really want to be in the business of leasing used equipment. They are only offering a service for folks needing to start up a business or add equipment to an existing business that the business owner doesn't have the capital to purchase or doesn't want to part with a large sum of money at once. It's still going to be yours. Once you have made the necessary payments, the lessor will have a buyout or a final fee due. Usually, this amounts to $1 in most cases, but some leases are shorter and require a larger buyout. Let's talk financing first. You probably already know how that works. You go to a lender, a bank, or finance company. They check to make sure that you absolutely don't need any money at all. You don't owe anyone and could care less if you're approved. Then they will approve you. The bank will often hold the title or deed or something of value as collateral. But sometimes if you are wealthy and have a perfect credit score, they will just have you sign a promissory note. If you make payments to the lender for the predetermined time, and they will make interest off the note. For example, you borrow $1,000 from the bank. They often will charge an annual percentage rate, but it sometimes break it into a monthly rate. So that they'll tell you that you're financing something for 1.5% monthly, which equates to 18% annually. When you're done making the required payments, you're done. No buyout. Leasing, though, is different. The biggest difference or benefit is that credit isn't really that big of a deal. There are some lease companies that only look at your credit to make sure you aren't defaulting on or have current leasing judgments against you. You could have just finished bankruptcy, lost your house, your dog, and 2 cars. Some lease companies will still make the lease for you. Leases for equipment really don't use interest rates. They basically figure an amount that is required to pay back based on an amount you borrowed. Take, for example, a rental couch. That couch may only cost the rental company $265. But they will have payments for about $7 a week for 18 months. This equates to $546. See how they trick you with the mini weekly type payments? Is that most people think that there are only 4 weeks in a month. Times that by 12 and you get 48 weeks. But the truth is that there are 52 weeks in a year, an extra month's worth of weeks. So 18 months is really 78 weeks. With a lease, they will require monthly payments for, say, 36 months. Let's assume you lease $5,000 in equipment. They may require $7,500 in return. $7,500 divided by 36 payments equals $208.83. No interest, but really, it's still a profit for the lessor. You will probably have a buyout, though, but that may only be a dollar. Essentially, the lease company is taking on the risk that a bank will not, and so they can charge more for this service. Keep in mind, depending on the leasing company, they may charge more, and many will charge less. Some may lease you $5,000 in equipment, but only charge $6,000 or $6,500 in return. Leasing is huge, and it's needed. Even for the most successful established companies, a lease is considered anything, or a small lease is considered anything under $100,000. So you can even borrow more with a lease. Now, why would you? Okay? Why would you do a lease? Maybe you can't get a loan from a bank or finance company, or maybe the bank won't allow the equipment to stand as collateral against the loan. Most banks will want to know everything about the business before lending you money, but lease companies don't really care. Leasing is much simpler. They aren't tight on credit, and your bad credit may not even matter. Less paperwork and red tape lending laws in regard to leases as well. This means you get approved faster and have the money to do what you need. But still, why would you lease something that you are going to pay double or even triple the original cost? It comes down to choices. okay, and comes down to what you really want. Let's say you know that you can get started with your food cart or hot dog cart as soon as you can get one. Let's say that you know that you have what it takes to make it successful, that you have already done the due diligence required to be successful. You found a location, found out about permitting and licensing. You found a food supplier and even did some of the food cost workups. The only thing standing in your way now is not having the money to get started. You simply can't afford a new cart or trailer, or you don't want to use the cash you have saved up because you may need it as a buffer later. All too often, this is the case. I guarantee you that every day, and I'm talking every single day, 365 days a year, I am told by one caller or another something to that effect. Ben, I don't have the money. I have everything in place and even found a cart I want, but I just don't have the money. So you have a choice. You can do nothing. Don't accept a lease because it's going to cost you three times what you borrowed. Don't start the business and go find something else to do. Maybe work for someone else or anything else that doesn't require your own money. Or you weigh out the real costs. You determine what the actual costs are. Let's do that now. Let's compare nothing versus something. Nothing is easy. Okay? We'll all agree. Doing nothing is pretty easy. Expenses? Nothing. And income? Nothing. And that pretty much covers all the nothings. Now, something is a little bit different. Something is mo better gooda. And what we'll need to do is do the math first. Okay? We'll figure out and we'll weigh out the risk versus the rewards. Let's say we want a brand new hot dog cart from benscarts.com. Let's say a big dog. And it's going to cost us about $3,000. We can get a lease for $210 a month for 24 months. We can do the math on that. 24 times 210 is $5,040. Now, let's figure out what the costs are really per day. Okay? So what we're going to do is take the 210 a month and divide that by 30 days. And what we will get is about $7 a day. But I'm not running a cart for 30 days a month, and neither will you. So now we need to know the daily average cost. How much does that 210 affect our daily overhead of operations? Because it really doesn't matter on the days you're not using it, because you only want to factor in the total cost of the month, your lease money, the total monthly payment over the days that you work. That's the most fair way to do it and honest way to do it if you want a real cost. And let's say you plan on working only 4 days a week. You're taking 3 days off every week. That's about 20 days a month. So divide 210 by 20 and you get $10.50 daily cost. Still not too bad, huh? Now, there are vendors who lease their carts to other vendors. I'm sure you're aware of this. If you've watched my videos, if you've been through my free training at learnhotdogs.com or have kept up with the Hot Dog Vendor Radio Show, we've talked about it several times on there. And how much do they pay, though? Would you believe it's anywhere from $50 to $150 daily? It is. I used to do it. And right now, I could place an ad in my local Craigslist that says, "Lease my hot dog cart. Make cash daily. You keep what you make. Only $85. My phone will blow the hell up. I know because I used to lease out carts, over 20 of them. But now, with leasing companies, you can get the money for your entire business. $85 a day so that you can take someone else's hot dog cart, go out and make $200, $300, $400 or more isn't that bad, okay? Many people are doing it. But if you are planning on starting your own business, you have done all your due diligence, and are serious about taking control of your life, then why wouldn't you lease a cart? Remember, it's only about $10.50 per day that you operate. Those are the real numbers. So now, what if you go out, you start making $180 a day? Not overwhelming business, but it's okay. You may work 4 to 5 hours a day. That would give you an average of 36 hourly income, and we haven't even figured out the hourly cost of your lease yet. So let's do that now. $210 a month was about $10.50 a day based on working 20 days a month. If you worked it out hourly for 5 hours a day, that would be $2 an hour. roughly? Can you make enough with your hot dog cart to pay $2 an hour for a lease? Well, I think you can. I think you can afford $2. If you have been over to learnhotdogs.com/training, have learned from the articles, the free training, the guest training articles and tips and tricks, the video tutorials and all of the rest, then you know the answer is yes, you can. Thousands of vendors are doing it and you can too. And they'd go, oh my gosh, it's $264 a month for the lease. Or, oh my gosh, it was $219 or $158 a month for the lease. And they're thinking, wow, that's, you know, a car payment a month. But a car isn't going to make you any money. It's mostly just a liability. But a hot dog cart is a business. And where can you get a business for $2 an hour? Where? And only pay for the hours where you're working, because that's how we base the numbers off of. You know, I could make it sound even mo gooda betta if I divided your payments over all the hours available in a year, but you're not working all the hours in a year. You got to sleep some, watch Oprah, Jerry Springer, fish, and then fish. And so it would be pointless to use all the hours. Yeah, you'd end up with something like 19 cents an hour, but that wouldn't be honest. And so honestly, if you can take your card out and it only costs you $2 to make 36, 50, 100, how can you not afford it? I wish you well. Happy vending. Please stay tuned to learnhotdogs.com. Sign up maybe for the newsletter. And we're over on Facebook too. So check us out. Y'all have a good day. Thanks for listening.